हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू नागेश करजके ऑर्किड स्कूल। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन आवर लास्ट सेशन वी हैव स्टार्टेड एक्सरसाइज 3.3 एंड फ्रॉम दैट एक्सरसाइज वी हैव सीन फर्स्ट 6 स्टोरी सम्स। ओके, नाउ रिमेनिंग स्टोरी सम्स टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी। सो सी, ओपन योर टेक्स्ट बुक पेज नंबर 42। कीप द टेक्स्ट बुक इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू। यू हैव टू रीड द क्वेश्चन इन योर mind, okay? So now we will see the question number 8. What is the question number 8? By how much is 3749 greater than 2954? What is the question? By how much is 3749 greater than 2954? Again the same thing here, that given us one hint. Okay, see, what is the hint that given us? That given us one picture, you see in your textbook also. See, this full part is 3749. Okay, now by how much is 3749 greater than 2954? Suppose that 2954 part is this part. This is the 2954. Okay. See, this 3749 is a greater number and this is a smaller number. If we will subtract this number from 3749, then we will get the other number. Okay. And that is our answer. So, do the subtraction. This is 4 digit number, so put the number in the place value chart. 3749 minus 2954. See the ones place, 9 minus 4, where is it? Is 9 minus 4 is equal to what? 5. See the tens place. At tens place, in the first number there are 4 tens and in another number there are 5 tens. 4 minus 5. Can we do 4 minus 5? No, we can't do 4 minus 5 because 4 is smaller than 5. Okay. So, what we will do? Just cut this 4 and write as it is here and then go to the neighbor. Now, neighbor is having 7. So, take 1 borrow from this 7. 7 minus 1, if we will do, here 6 will remain and this 4 will become 14. Now do the subtraction. 14 minus 5. 14 minus 5, after 5, count your fingers, still 14. 5, 14 minus 5 is equal to 9. So write 9 at tens place. Then go to the hundreds place. Here 6 is there, here 9 is there. Again the same problem, 6 minus 9 we can't do because 6 is smaller than 9. So just cut this 6 and write as it is here and then go to the neighbor. Now neighbor is having 3, so take 1 borrow from this 3. So cut to the 3. 3 minus 1 is equal to 2 and here we will take 1 borrow from thousands place. Okay, see the hundreds place. Now here 16 is there, here 9 is there. 16 minus 9 you can do. Now do the subtraction. After 9, count your fingers till 16. So count your fingers. Yes, 16 minus 9 is equal to 7. So write 7 at hundreds place. See the thousands place. Here 2 is there, here also 2 is there. 2 minus 2, if we will do, what will remain? 0 will remain. Okay, so what is our answer? The answer is 795. So how will you write the answer? By how much is 3749 greater than 2954. See students, what you have to do? Just you have to cut the question word by how much. Okay, and instead of that word you have to put this number and write the answer in your sentence. Okay, then we'll move to the next, 9th one. What is the 9th one question? Read the question. 9th one question is, Ramu had to travel 7849 kilometers. He traveled 5672 kilometers by aeroplane and the rest by train. What distance did he travel by train? See students, what is the question? Ramu had to travel total 7849 kilometers. Okay, so first of all we will write Ramu had to travel. Ramu had to travel. How much distance? 7849 kilometer. Km means what? It is the short form of kilometer. Then he traveled 5672 kilometers by aeroplane. So what we will write here? He traveled by aeroplane 5672 kilometer. And what is the question? What distance did he travel by train? Okay, now see, Ramu had to travel this much distance, that is 7849. Okay, out of this total distance he traveled by aeroplane 5672 kilometer, and remaining distance he will travel by the train. So that we have to find out what distance did he travel by the train. So what we will do, just we will subtract the distance traveled by aeroplane from the total number of distance, then we will get the distance traveled by the train. Okay, so do the subtraction. Both are 4-digit numbers. So draw the place value chart and write the numbers in that place value chart. The first number is 7849 minus how much distance he traveled by the aeroplane? 5672. Do the subtraction. 9 minus 2. See the ones place. Here 9 is there, here 2 is there. 9 minus 2, very easy. After 2, count your fingers till 9. 9 minus 2, 7. See the tens place column. Here 4 is there and here 7 is there. 4 minus 7. Can we do 4 minus 7? No, we can't do 4 minus 7. So what we will do? Just cut this 4 and write as it is. And then go to the neighbor. Who is the neighbor of tens? 100 is the neighbor of tens. Okay. So take one borrow from the neighbor. Now this neighbor is having 8. So take one borrow from the 8. 8 minus 1, here 7 will remain and this 4 will become 14. Now do the subtraction at tens place. Here 14 is there and here 7 is there. 14 minus 7, now you can do. After 7, count your fingers till 14. 14 minus 7 is equal to 7. So write 7 at ones place. Go to the hundreds place now. Here 7 is there, here 6 is there. Where is this? 7 minus 6 is equal to 1. So write 1 at hundreds place. Okay, then what is remaining? Thousands place is remaining. Here 7 is there, here 5 is there. 7 minus 5, 7 minus 5, what? 2. So write 2 at thousands place. So what is the answer? The answer is 2177. Then this answer we have to write in the sentence. How will you write the answer in the sentence? See the question. What distance did he travel by train? So what we will do, just we will remove the question word, that is what, and instead of that word we will put the answer. Okay, so how will you write? 2177 kilometer he traveled by the train. So in this way you can write the answer in your own sentence also. Okay, understood till this question? Okay, then we'll move to the next, that is question number 10. Read the question. What is the question? See, the question is, a train can hold 2,348 people. A train can hold 2,348 people. Means this is the capacity of train. What is the capacity of train? Train can hold 2,348 people. On Sunday, 1,679 people travelled by the train. How many more could have travelled in the train? See, train can hold how many people? 2,348 means 2,348 people can travel by the train, means that is the capacity of train. But on Sunday only 1,679 people traveled by the train. Then what is the question? How many more people could have traveled in the train? So what we will do? Yes, just we will subtract this 1,679 from 2,348. So, how will write the answer? A train can hold 2,348 people. You can write the given sentence as it is. Okay. But on Sunday, only 1,679 people travelled by train. On Sunday, number of people travelled by train is equal to what? 1,679. Now do the subtraction. These many people can travel by the train, but on Sunday only 1,679 people were traveled by the train. Then if we will do the subtraction, then we will get the number of people more could have travelled in the train. So do the subtraction at 1 plus 8, and here 9 is there. 8 minus 9 here also again we can't do, because 8 is smaller than 9. So just cut this 8 and write as it is, and then go to the neighbour. Who is the neighbour of 1's? 10's is the neighbour of 1's. Now this 10's is having 4. Do the subtraction. 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. Why? Because we are going to give one borrow to the 1. Okay, so here we will do the subtraction. 4 minus 1 3, and here 8 will become 18. Do the subtraction now. 18 minus 9, after 9 count your fingers, still 18. 18 minus 9 is equal to 9. Then see the tens place. Here 3 is there and here 7 is there. Again 3 minus 7 we can't do. So again what we will do, just cut this 3 and write as it is, and then go to the neighbor. Neighbor is having 3 here. So take one borrow from this 3. So here 2 will remain and this 3 will become 13. Okay. Then 13 minus 7. Do the subtraction. 13 minus 7 is equal to 6. So write 6 at tens place. Then see the hundreds place. Here how many remaining now? Here 2 are remaining and here 6 are there. 2 minus 6. Can we do 2 minus 6? No, we can't do 2 minus 6. Then what we will do? Just cut this 2, write as it is, then go to the neighbor. Now this neighbor is having 2. Take one borrow from this neighbor. So 2 minus 1, here 1 will remain and this 2 will become 12. Now do the subtraction. 12 minus 6. You can do very easily now. 12 minus 6 is equal to what? After 6, count your fingers till 12. Yes. 12 minus 6 is equal to what? 6. So write 6 at hundreds place. Okay. Then go to the thousands place. Here 1 is there and here also 1 is there. 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Okay. So what is the answer? The answer is 669 more could have traveled in the train. So in this way you can write the answer in the sentence. Okay. Shall we move to the next question? Question number 11. See the question number 11, what it is? Read the question. By how much is 879 less than 2068? See students, this question is similar to question number 8. Okay, so what you have to do, just I will explain, and that question you have to solve by your own. What you have to do, see, you have to draw one diagram, you have to refer the question number 8, because both questions are similar. Okay, so see, what is the greater number? 2068. Okay, and what is the smaller number? 879. See the question, by how much is 879 less than 2068? So if you will do the subtraction, then you will get the answer. Okay, so you have to solve this question by your own. Then we will see the last question. What is the last question? 12th number. Priya's father earns rupees 9500 per month. He saves rupees 1230 per month. How much does he spend each month? See, he earns rupees 9500 per month. Priya's father earns, so we'll write, he earns rupees 9500 per month. Okay, Priya's father earn rupees 9500 per month. Okay, then out of 9500, how much he save? He saves rupees 1230 per month. So what we will write here, he saves rupees 1230 per month. Okay, and what is the question? How much does he spend each month? See, he is getting total amount 9500 per month, and from that 9500 he saves 1230, and the remaining amount he spent in each month. So for that we will do the subtraction. Now here, thousands, hundreds, tens and ones, which one is greater number? He earns rupees 9500. 9500 is the greater number. So first of all, we will write that number. Then he saves rupees 1230. And remaining number he spent in each month. Remaining amount of money he spent in each month. See the ones place here, 0, here also 0 is there. 0 minus 0 is equal to 0. Then see the tens place. Here 0 is there, here 3 is there. 0 minus 3. Can we do 0 minus 3? No. Then what you will do? Just cut this 0 right as it is, and then go to the neighbor. Who is the neighbor of tens? This 100 is the neighbor of tens. Now 100 is having 5. So take one borrow from this 100. So 5 minus 1, 4. So here 4 will remain, and this 0 will become 10. Now see the tens place, here 10 is there, here 3 is there. Do the subtraction. 10 minus 3 is equal to what? 10 minus 3 is equal to 7. Okay, then see the hundreds place, here 4 is there, here 2 is there. 4 minus 2 is equal to what? 2. So write 2 at hundreds place. See the thousands place, here 9 is there and here 1 is there. 9 minus 1, do the subtraction. What will be the answer? 9 minus 1, 8. Okay, so how much money he spent in each month? He spent rupees 8270 per month. Okay, so write the answer in the sentence. He spent rupees 8270 per month. Understood? So in this way we have completed exercise 3.3. Now we are going to solve exercise 3.4. So in that exercise, we will see the question, what it is. See See, in that exercise, what you have to do? You have to do the addition as well as subtraction. Okay? See the first question, exercise 3.4. The first one is 3,231 plus 4,235 minus 6,231. So, how will you solve this? First, you have to add the first number to the number with the plus sign before it. First, what you have to do? First, you have to take the first number compulsory. You have to take. What is the first number? The first number is 3,231. Then, what you have to do? Add the first number to the number with the plus sign before it. You have to do the addition. Okay? Now, you have to add this number to the number which is having plus sign. Okay? Now, first compulsory first number you have to take. So, first of all, we will write first number. Then, these two numbers are remaining. Now, see students. In these two numbers, which number is having plus sign before it? Which number is having plus sign? This or this? Yes, this 4,235 is having plus sign before it. Okay? So, first we will take this number 4,235. Then, first of all, we will do the addition of these two numbers. Okay? Now, do the addition. First of all, we will write this number in a vertically. Okay? All are 4-digit numbers. 3,231 plus, what is the second number? 4,235. Do the addition. 1 plus 5, 6. 3 plus 3, 6. 2 plus 2, 4. 3 plus 4, 7. Okay? Now, here we got the answer 7,466. Now, from this sum, what you have to do? From the sum, subtract the number with the minus sign before it. So, for that, first of all, we will write this sum. Now, we got this answer. This is the addition. Okay? Now, we got this answer. So, first of all, we will write this number here, which we got now 7,466. Write their places. This is 1000, this is 100, this is tens and ones. Now, what you have to do? You have to subtract the number which is having minus sign before it. Now, which one number is having minus sign before it? This 6,231. So, write this number and do the subtraction. 6,231. Do the subtraction. 6 at 1 plus 6 here and here 1 is there. 6 minus 1 is equal to what? 5. So, write 5 here at 1's place. See the tens place column. Here 6 is there. Here 3 is there. 6 minus 3. 6 minus 3 what? 6. 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. So, write 3 at tens place. Then we'll move to the hundreds place. Here 4 is there. Here 2 is there. 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. And here at thousands place, here 7 is there. Here 6 is there. 7 minus 6 is equal to 1. Okay, so here what answer we got? We got the answer 1,235. So finally here you can write the answer, that is 1,235. Miss, see students, what you have to do? First compulsory, you have to write the first number as it is. Okay, first number as it is you have to write. Then what you have to do? Then you have to add the number which number is having plus sign before it. Okay, compulsory first number we will write here. First we will take first number only. Okay, now remaining two numbers we have to see. In these two numbers, which number is having plus sign before it? This 4,235 is having plus sign. So we will take this number and then we will do the addition of these two numbers here. Okay, then whatever sum we will get, sum means answer, addition. Okay, whatever sum we will get from this sum, see, from this sum we will subtract the number which number is having minus sign. Now here in the question, this number is having minus sign. So we will do the subtraction. Okay, if we will do the subtraction, whatever answer we will get, that is our final answer. So here at the end we have to write the answer. So in this way, first we have to do the addition part, and then whatever sum we will get, from that sum we will subtract the remaining number, then we will get our final answer. Okay. Then we will see the third one. See, in the exercise there are total 10 sums are there. Okay, out of that total 10 sums we will see the odd number sums. Okay, so we will see now third number. What is the third number question? 5323 minus 2349 plus 1234. What is our first step? First we have to write the first number compulsory. What is the first number? This 5323. This is our first number. This first number we have to take as it is compulsory. Okay, then what is the next step? Yes, now we have to see these two remaining numbers. Okay, see these two remaining number, 2349 and 1234. Now you tell me, out of these two numbers, which number is having plus sign before it? See this number, this number is having minus sign. Okay, and this number is having plus sign before it. So we will take this number now. What is the number? Plus 1234. Now what you will do? Very simple. Now you have to do the addition of these two numbers. So let us do the addition. 5323 plus 1234. Do the addition. 3 plus 4, count your fingers after 3 plus 4 7. Then see the tens place. Here 2 is there, here 3 is there. 2 plus 3 5. Here also 3 plus 2 5. And at thousands place, here 5 is there, here 1 is there. 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. Okay, now this sum we got, the sum 6557. So first this sum we will write as it is here, 6557. Now what is our next step? Now we have to see the number that which number is having minus sign before it. Okay, now which number is having minus sign? This 2349 is having minus sign. Okay, so do the subtraction here, 2349. Now see here, 7 minus 9. Can we do 7 minus 9? No, we can't do 7 minus 9. Why? Because 7 is smaller than 9. So here we can't do the 7 subtraction. So what we will do? Just cut this 7 and write as it is. Then we will go to the next place. Here 5 is there. So take one borrow from this 5. Okay, so 5 minus 1, 4. So we will cut this 5 and write 4 at the top of the 5. Okay, and this 7 will become 70. Now do the subtraction. At once place, here 17 is there and here 9 is there. 17 minus 9. Count your fingers after 9 till 17. 17 minus 9 is equal to 8. So write 8 at ones place. Now we'll move to the tens place. See, in the first number there are 4 tens, and in the second number also there are 4 tens. So 4 minus 4. 4 minus 4 is equal to what? 0. Then see the hundreds place. Here 5 is there, here 3 is there. So 5 minus 3, 5 minus 3, 2. So write 2 at hundreds place. Then go to the thousands place. Here 6 is there, here 2 is there. 6 minus 2, do the subtraction. 6 minus 2 is equal to 4. So what is our final answer? The answer is 4208. Okay, so what you have to do? Once again I will tell you what you have to do. See the numbers carefully. Three numbers that given us, three numbers. Okay, in the first step we have to write the first number compulsory as it is. Okay, then we have to see the remaining two numbers. Okay, from these two numbers, which number is having plus sign before it? That number we have to take here. And in the first step, we have to do the addition. Okay, after addition, whatever sum we will get, from that sum, we have to subtract the remaining number. Now here, this number is having negative sign, minus sign. So we will take this number here and we will do the subtraction here. And this is our final answer. So in this way, you can solve this example. Okay, then we will take one more example, that is fifth one. Read the number. What is the first number? The first number is 533, which is a 3-digit number. Then what is the second number? Second number is 6829, 4-digit number. And the third number is also a 3-digit number. Then what is the rule? The first rule is, first number we have to take as it is. So write first number as it is. Okay, then what we have to do? We have to see the remaining two numbers. Okay, see the remaining two numbers. Now which number is having plus sign before it? See, 6829 and 323. Out of these two number, which number is having plus sign before it? Yes, this number is having plus sign before it. So we will take this number here and we'll do the addition. Do the addition now. This is a 3-digit number. Draw the place value chart and put the number in that chart. 533, this is a 3-digit number, so start from the hundreds place. And what is the next number? 6829. Do the addition. 3 plus 9 at ones place, here 3 is there. 3 plus 9 is equal to 12. 12 ones means 2 ones and 1 10. So 1 we will give as a carry to the tens place. Now see the tens place, here 1 is there, here 3 is there and 2 is there. 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. 4 plus 2, 6. So write 6 at tens place. Then go to the hundreds place. Here 5 is there, here 8 is there. 500 plus 800, 5 plus 8, 13. Now 13 hundreds means 300 and 1000. So 1 we will give as a carry to the hundreds place. Now thousands place. Now see the thousands place. Here 1 and here 6 is there. 1 plus 6 is equal to 7. Now we got this sum, 7362. Now what is the next step? We have to write this sum as it is in the step 2. What is the answer? 7362. Okay, write their places. Now from this sum, what we have to do? We have to subtract the number, that which number is having negative sign, minus sign. See the number, this number. Okay, 323. So we will subtract 323 from 7362. Do the subtraction. 2 minus 3. Can we do 2 minus 3? No, we can't do 2 minus 3 because 2 is smaller than 3. So what we will do? Just cut this 2, write as it is here at the top of 2, and then go to the next place. At next place, here 6 is there. So take one borrow from this 6. 6 minus 1, 5. So here at tens place, 5 will remain and this 2 will become 12. Now see the ones place. 12 minus 3. 12 minus 3, after 3, count your fingers till 12. So 12 minus 3, 9. So write 9 at ones place. Then see the tens place, here 5 is there, here 2 is there. 5 minus 2, where is the 5 minus 2 is equal to 3. So write 3 at tens place. Then we will move to the hundreds place column. Here 3 is there, here also 3 is there. 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. Because we have seen one of the property of subtraction, that if we subtract a number from that number itself, we will get the answer 0. According to that property, 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. So write 0 at hundreds place. Then we will move to the thousands place. Here only 7 is there. So 7 minus 0 is equal to 7. So what is the answer? The answer is 7039. This is our final answer. Okay. So see students, today we have started exercise 3.4. Okay, so from that We have seen few examples and few more examples are remaining that you have to solve by your own. So you have to do the practice of exercise 3.3 as well as exercise 3.4 in your CW. Okay, thank you.